Right. Welcome back to Daily Update, my 1000 Day Challenge. This is day 346, so let's get things started. All right, first and foremost, although the balance looks the same to be here, but actually I've been stopped out in terms of experimental trade set up for Bitcoin itself because I was in a short trade. So there was stopped out, so it should be dropping around 50 plus, including our fees and slippages and stuff. All right. Otherwise, if you look in terms of the market structure updates, today is Monday. The only main change will be on the weekly chart for Bitcoin itself. So it still remains bearish. But more importantly, if you look in terms of the candlestick closing or so-called price action itself, what you do see on the weekly chart is a little bit more bearish. Reason being is very simple. So let's zoom in a little bit. So if you zoom in a little bit just on this reason itself, you will see that we're very much closing at least above this 0.5 Fibonacci retracement for 1 week, 2 week, 3 week, 4, 5, 6, 7 or 7 consecutive weeks ever since we broke down since the 17th of May, that particular week itself. And now the bearish thing is they've actually closed slightly below. So we actually closed at a new low if you're talking about this recent time itself, ever since here, ever since the start of the year itself. So yeah, things aren't looking that good in general in terms of Bitcoin. So I do see that potentially we could have a further retest and we could potentially be seeing even 27K or even potentially lower. But the question is, how long will we stay at the lower level is a very big question mark. So personally, for me, for myself, in terms of long-term investment, I'm definitely staying invested. Reason is I can simply time the bottom and the top consistently. And if you actually do a very sharp drop and a very sharp rebound, I may not be able to catch it at the same price where I'm right now just as well, and that's also taking a very large chances in this particular case. So in my opinion, this would be a little bit too greedy in order to just sell here hoping to buy back here. And yeah, and moreover, I do look in terms of long-term wise, like say for example towards the end of the year or even next year itself, I do see it hitting the retesting the previous one, the all-time high itself over here, the 60 over K region and beyond. So yep, I'm still definitely staying invested. Yep, and otherwise, in terms of the daily chart, we do see some small little bearish action just as well. Especially, we can see that we are still being somewhat suppressed or somewhat below the 20 exponential moving average price. Do bear in mind that moving averages are formed as a result of the price and not the other way around. So it's not so-called like the moving averages are pushing the price down, but it was said that the selling pressure is strong enough that the prices never overcome the 20 exponential moving average, which is the 20 candlestick itself in the past. Yeah, so hopefully we do retest this 50 simple moving average soon. I can see it flatlining itself. So potentially we could have a break towards the upside, or potentially we could have a very strong downside first to just stop out people who are potentially in a long setup or in a highly leveraged position and stuff like that. So that could be another way. So in any other case, I will just be staying inside my this particular trade, which I've really shorted, and I'll just stick to it. Yep. So with that said, I've come to the end of today. If you guys have any questions, feel free to drop by your comments below. Otherwise, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.